What's up, this is Tom, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to fix your cumulative layout shift in WordPress. Now you can use GT metrics to measure this, but I really recommend using the cumulative layout shift debugger on the Web Vitals website. I'll leave a link to this in the video description, but this actually creates a GIF showing you all the shifting elements on your site. If you load your site in a browser, it's probably too quick for you to notice, but things might be shifting, and this can be related to fonts, asynchronous CSS, animations, or things that don't have specified dimensions like images, iframes, or even ads. You can also use PageSpeed Insights to see any elements that have large layout shifts. Or in WebPageTest, they have a cumulative layout shift score, and if you click this, it will also show a GIF. CLS is currently 15% of Core Web Vitals. It used to be 5%, but just in the last version 8, they increased it from 5 to 15. So just know that there is more weight on CLS in Core Web Vitals now. And to improve it, you want to aim for a CLS score of 0.1 or less. Anything over will either need improvement or score as poor. I currently have a CLS score of 0, but if you update WP Rocket, sometimes this can change. I feel like there's a lot of issues with CLS and WP Rocket at the moment, and they need to figure things out. And I did write an article covering cumulative layout shift in WordPress, which I'll leave a link to in the video description. But without further ado, let's get into it. Fonts are a very common issue when it comes to cumulative layout shift. Now, if you check your PageSpeed Insights report and you see you need to ensure text remains visible during web font load, then chances are they're contributing to your CLS. The first step to optimizing fonts is to make sure they are hosted locally and not being pulled from third-party font websites like fonts.gstatic.com. If they are, you can use plugins like OMGF or Transfonter to host your fonts locally. And this will make it so your fonts are being served from your website. Mine is onlinemediamasters.com, but you'll see that none of my fonts are being served from fonts.gstatic.com. The next step to optimizing fonts is to avoid FOIT and FOUT. FOIT is flash of invisible text and happens when you don't have a fallback font. So while your font is being loaded, you're not going to see anything, it's just going to be a blank white page. But in FOUT, flash of unstyled text, you're going to see there's a fallback font, and that is loaded until the regular font is loaded. To fix this, you're going to add font display swap. So if you ever downloaded Google Fonts from their website, you'll notice they add this automatically to the end of the URL. But if you need to do this yourself, then you can use the Swap Google Fonts Display plugin. Just note that this is only for Google Fonts, and it automatically adds Font Display Swap to those URLs. If you're hosting fonts locally, which is what you should be doing, then you're going to use the String Locator plugin to find all your font files. What you're going to do is use the GT Metrics waterfall chart, go to the Fonts tab, click your fonts, and then just search for the last part of the URL where the font is. So you're going to go ahead and paste that here, and String Locator is going to show you where your fonts are located. So here you can see this is in my style.css, and this is where most of my fonts are. It really depends on your theme and CSS, but in most cases, you're going to find the font face and add font display swap into the font style sheet. Now, if you're using WP Rocket, they automatically add font display swap in three situations: if you enable Optimize Google Fonts, Minify CSS, or Combine, as well as Optimize CSS Delivery, they will add font display swap. But if you retest your site and still need to ensure text remains visible during web font load, then you may be running into issues and you need to solve them with font display swap. Now, I'll be the first to admit that I'm not a CSS wizard or anything close to it, but there is a nice article I found on WPMU that covers common issues when using font display swap, and I'll leave a link to this in the video description. But adding font display swaps should fix the ensure text remains visible during web font load item in PageSpeed Insights, which should also help improve CLS. Another way to fix layout shift issues with fonts is to preload them. you need to make sure you're hosting fonts locally on your server and they're not being pulled from fonts.gstatic.com before you preload them. Once you do that, then you can go into your waterfall chart and go to the fonts tab and just copy your font URLs and paste them into the preload tab in WP Rocket. If you're not using WP Rocket, you can use plugins like pre-party resource hints or perf matters, or even do this manually by adding it to your header.php file. Just make sure that you do testing while you're preloading fonts, because preloading too many can actually have a negative effect. But if they're loading across your entire website, then chances are you can preload them, but this will help fix any CLS issues related to fonts as well. The next issue has to do with optimized CSS delivery in WP Rocket, or if you're using Lightspeed Cache, loading CSS asynchronously. This is a very common issue with Cumulative Layout Shift. I personally have it disabled, but if you do have it enabled, sometimes the CSS delivery causes FOUC, flash of unstyled content. To fix this, they have a little article about it, but it is related to the CSS delivery option. Like I said, I personally have it disabled, but the other option is you can set a fallback critical CSS. And the way to do that is to go to a CSS generator. I'll leave a link to this one in the video description, and you're going to just enter your site, enter your homepage, and click generate critical path CSS. Copy the CSS and paste it into the fallback right here. You should retest your CLS after you do this to see if it made an improvement, but I would also test your CLS with optimized CSS delivery off. No matter what I did, even setting a fallback and troubleshooting, making sure optimized CSS delivery is working by finding this in the source code, no matter what I did, it was causing layout shifts. So I ultimately chose to disable it, but if you want to use it, that is how to do it. You want to make sure it's working by searching for rocket-critical-css in your source code, and also set a fallback critical CSS. If you're using Lightspeed or another plugin, try disabling load CSS asynchronously, or if you have it on, try generating a critical CSS. Another way to fix Cumulative Layout Shift in WordPress is to make sure that your elements have an explicit width and height. Now, if you view your source code, you will see that every time you add an image, it should add a width and a height to the HTML. Now, if it doesn't, you can either go into your image HTML manually and add it, or if you're using a plugin like WP Rocket, the add missing image dimensions should fix this. This also happens with iframes or even advertisements if you're using Google Ads. You need to specify dimensions and reserve space, because if you don't reserve space for that content, then it's going to cause layout shifts. Animations can also cause layout shifts. Now, if you are using animations, I recommend at least disabling them on mobile specifically, just because they can add a lot of load time and Google is mobile first. But if you insist on having animations, then you should use the transform and translate option. Now, I have this in an Elementor demo site, but to add this, I actually used the Happy Add-ons for Elementor plugin, and this actually makes it so there are settings where you can use the CSS transform property. And this allows you to animate elements without causing layout shifts. The last and final tip to reduce cumulative layout shift in WordPress is if you're using Oxygen Builder. I personally don't use Oxygen, although I'm open to it eventually, but if you are using it, there is a GitHub form here. Basically, you have to set the default font or the global font to Mulish. Don't ask me why, but I just wanted to include this for those of you using Oxygen Builder, that this may be something that reduces layout shifts. Otherwise, I hope this video was helpful, and if you have any questions, leave me a comment. Otherwise, peace out.